Everybody, it's me, Myra, at Down Home Money, a simple approach to financial freedom. I hope you're doing well. So today, I've got three things you must do before the end of the year. Are you ready? Okay, so number one. So first of all, can you believe that 2021, I mean, it's just so hard to believe that here we are, it's gone. I mean, it just seems like yesterday that COVID happened in February of 2020, and here we all are. Now we're ending 2021, and we're coming up on 2 years of COVID. Wow. I think it's so important that for 2022, that we get real purposeful on what it is we want. Because I feel like that a lot of us have been kind of just waiting around, hoping COVID will end. And what I have found, and especially with the Great Resignation, there's been a lot of disruption in people's lives, the way they were living. And with this disruption, it also caused people to really evaluate where they are. And so that's number one today. Number one is evaluate exactly where you are. So what that can mean is sit down. I just need you to spend about an hour before the end of the year and do this. And that way you can drive 2022 to wherever you want it to go. But without a plan and without a map, and without knowing exactly what it is you truly want, you're not going to get anywhere. We're going to be at the end of 2022, and you're going to be saying, wow, it's the end of 2022, and I didn't reach any of my goals. But there's a reason that you've got to evaluate where you are, because if we know where we are, it's easier for us to plan where we want to go. So, number one, spend about 30 minutes. Sit down. Evaluate 2021. What was good? What was bad? What do you want to do more of? What do you want to do less of? Evaluate it so that you can set the goals for 2022 on how you want to be purposeful with your life. And one of those things is when you're looking at and evaluating where you've been, is you need to look at your finances and you need to determine where you are. And as you all know, you can go to my website, Down Home Money. I'll put the link down below, downhomemoney.com. And you can go to that. And I have on Money Tools, you can click on Money Tools, and then you can pull up a net worth sheet. And you guys, knowing your net worth is crucial. It's crucial. And it's so easy that you, if you don't want to do that, pull out a piece of paper. Get you a piece. Y'all know I love a whiteboard. Here we go. Pull you out a piece of paper and right at the top of the paper, net worth. And draw a line down the middle of it. On one side, list assets. On the other side, list liabilities. And list your assets and your liabilities. Assets, your home, your car, your boat, your motorhome, your motorcycle, your bank accounts, your retirement plan. Those are your assets, anything that's tangible. Your furnishings in your home, you need to use garage sale values. So you're going to write down what it is. So there's your home. If your home's worth $350,000, you're going to come right here. Let me do that for you so you'll see what I'm talking about, because you're going to also run a column on what the values are, okay? So if your home's worth $350,000, there's the value. Your car's worth $30,000, and this is today's value. If you paid $50,000, but the car Kelley Blue Book is $30,000, that's what you put on assets, okay? So if you owe, then you're going to come over here, car loan, and you're going to put whatever you owe right here. Your mortgage, whatever you owe right there on your mortgage. On your credit card, how much do you owe? Student loans, you can just list all the way down, okay? And then once you have all your assets listed, and then you have all your liabilities, You're going to tally these numbers. You're going to tally them at the bottom. And assets minus liabilities, that is your net worth. So you guys, if you're in your 20s and 30s, it's probably going to be a negative number. You're probably going to owe more money than you have. If you're in your 40s, 50s, 60s, it's time to start preparing. You need to have a positive net worth because you've been working a lot of years to not have any net worth, because that number represents your life and all the work you have done. That's why it's so important to give every month to your retirement plan, and we've talked about that. So let's evaluate where you are. Number one of the three that you've got to do before the end of the year is we're going to evaluate where we are. We're going to decide what was good, what was bad, what do we want more of. We're going to evaluate our net worth. So you're going to determine what is your net worth. And then number two, we're going to decide on what is it you want. So now we've evaluated, we know everything that we got in 2021. What did we do? What did we not do? And how we ended up right here in 2021. So now we've got to decide how are we going to get to where we want to be in 2022. And you cannot do that without setting goals and writing them down and reviewing them every day. I want you to know, my goal, I wanted to be a millionaire by the age 30. It took me to the age 33, so I did not hit my goal. But every day I would get up, I'd be brushing my teeth, and I had on my mirror, I'm gonna be a millionaire. My husband thought I was a little crazy, but that's okay too, because it worked. I would recite that to myself while I brush my teeth. Because when you're caught up in the working and the day-to-day, it's hard to remember why you're doing this. So number three is you've got to write down your goals. It's so important. And there's seven different categories you can do this for. So number one, your family goal. What is one of your family goals? What do you want to accomplish with your family? Number two, a financial goal. What's your financial goal for next year? Maybe it's to make so much money. Maybe it's to contribute to your retirement account so much money every single month. Maybe it's about building your reserves. Put time frames on it. Don't just say by the end of the year, say by the first quarter, I want to have this much. By the second quarter, break it down in quarters, break it down monthly if that helps you. Your third category is your health. That was probably one of the best things I did for myself. In 2018, I set a goal for my health and I started walking. I never worked out my whole life and I started walking, and now I started with 1 mile a day and now I'm at 5 miles a day. It takes me about an hour and a half. It is the best part of my day. It's the first thing I do in the morning and I love it because it gives me so much clarity because I have time to think about what I want to do throughout the day. So number four is a spiritual goal. And this may be, an example of this could be, make sure that you say a prayer every day, or you pray before you eat. This is just something for you. And maybe attend church more often, or that's just a very personal thing. And so you'll figure out what's right for you. Number five is your personal growth goal. So for me, also in 2018, I set a personal growth goal to read so many books, and I read over 100 books in 1 year. So now I try to read 2 books a month. And so that might be your personal growth. Another one could be, I want to learn how to play the guitar. So you could take guitar lessons. That would be a great one. Or maybe you want to learn to sew. This last year, I wanted to learn to cook. And my poor husband, bless his heart, but you know what? He got through it because I had to learn, right? It's all about being willing to fail forward. And so anyway, we had some not so great meals, but guess what? I've gotten better, so that's good. Number six is your career goals. What do you want to do for your career goals? Do you want to make more money? Do you want to work less? Do you want to work smarter instead of harder? get your goals together on what you want to accomplish in your career. Maybe you want a promotion. Set a deadline. What's the date? Maybe you need to tell somebody you want a promotion. So it's a matter of setting some goals and then reaching them. You got this. Number 7 is set a fun goal. What do you want to do for fun in 2022? Because all of this is not worth it if you're not having some fun. So set a goal to put fun on your calendar. All right, so that's number 3, setting your goals and getting those all figured out before we start 2022. We got to know all of this so that way we can start out the gate running to reach your goals in 2022. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see you next Tuesday. Don't forget to subscribe. Give us a thumbs up. We're about real estate, money, and life here at Down Home Money. Hey, you know another great thing for your goal setting? Go read my book. You can get it on Amazon. I also read it in Audible, but if you don't like the Southern accent, get the paperback. It'll be better for you. All right, but it's great information. It'll be a great way to launch your year. So I'll see you next Tuesday.